Check, check. Good.
Thank you.
Good evening, church. It is so good to come together this evening as we prepare to praise the name of our great God, to worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus. And church, tonight we are not going to be shy in the way that we worship. Tonight we are going to be boasting in the name of Jesus. So if you're being a bit of a wallflower and hanging up the back, please, I encourage you, let's stand shoulder to shoulder as we praise our Jesus. And as we worship his name and remember what he's done for us. All I have because of Jesus, and all this promise won for me, when he paid the highest ransom, once for always, for my freedom, I will boast in Christ alone, his righteousness, and not my own, and I will cling to Christ my hope, his mercy reigns now and forever. In Christ alone,
Father, nothing but the blood of Jesus can save us. We thank you for tonight. We thank you for the opportunity to worship you in your name. Lord, help us to sing with everything that we have and everything that we are. May tonight just be a night of surrendering our hearts to you in preparation for this weekend. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome tonight, church. Hey, so good to have you here. Hey, yes, that tonight is an opportunity just to worship our Lord and Savior. Just like the night before Jesus' crucifixion, he was there with his brothers. They were there together in fellowship. They're praying, singing hymns and psalms. And this is what we are here tonight as well doing. So tonight, what we are going to do in between the worship, we're going to have scripture readings from starting from the plot against Jesus, going to Jesus' arrest right before he was taken away and trialed with the crucifixion. So let me start. Matthew 26, starting from verse 1. When Jesus had finished saying all these things, he said to his disciples, "As you know, the Passover is 2 days away, and the Son of Man will be handed over to be crucified." Then the chief priests and the elders of the people assembled in the palace of the high priest, whose name was Caiaphas. And they schemed to arrest Jesus secretly and kill him. But not during the festival, they said, or there might be a riot among the people. While Jesus was in Bethany in the home of Simon the leper, a woman came to him with an alabaster jar of very expensive perfume, which she poured on his head as he was reclining at the table. When the disciples saw this, they were indignant. "Why this waste?" they asked. "This perfume could have been sold at a high price and the money given to the poor." Aware of this, Jesus said to them, "Why are you bothering this woman? She has done a beautiful thing to me. The poor you will always have with you, but you will not always have me. When she poured this perfume on my body, she did it to prepare me for burial. Truly, I tell you, wherever this gospel is preached throughout the world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her." Thank you, team.
Thank you. Matthew 26, verse 14 to 30. Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12 disciples, went to the leading priests and asked, "How much will you pay me to betray Jesus to you?" And they gave him 30 pieces of silver. From that time on, Judas began looking for an opportunity to betray Jesus. On the first day of the festival of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Where do you want us to prepare the Passover meal for you?" "As you go into the city," he told them, "you will see a certain man. Tell him, 'The teacher says, my time has come, and I will eat the Passover meal with my disciples at your house.'" So the disciples did as Jesus told them and prepared the Passover meal there. When it was evening, Jesus sat down at the table with the 12. While they were eating, he said, "I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me." Greatly distressed, each one asked in turn, "Am I the one, Lord?" He replied, "One of you has just eaten from this bowl with me will betray me. For the Son of Man must die, as the scriptures declared long ago. But how terrible it will be for the one who betrays him. It would be far better for that man if he had never been born." Judas, the one who would betray him, also asked, "Rabbi, am I the one?" And Jesus told him, "You have said it." As they were eating, Jesus took some bread and blessed it. Then he broke it in pieces and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this and eat it, for this is my body." And he took the cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it. He gave it to them and said, "Each of you drink from it, for this is my blood, which confirms the covenant between God and his people. It is poured out as a sacrifice to forgive the sins of many. Mark my words, I will not drink wine again until the day I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." Then they sang a hymn and went out to the Mount of Olives.
A crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. And when before the throne I stand in Jesus died my soul to save, my lips shall still repeat. And when before the throne I stand in him complete, Jesus died my soul to save, my lips shall still repeat. Paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed
What a price he paid. What a reason he gives us to sing and to praise his name.
Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss. The father turns his face away as wounds which mother chosen one bring many sons to sin upon his shoulders.
Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took Peter and the two sons of Zebedee along with him, and he began to feel sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Couldn't you men keep watch with me for 1 hour?" he asked Peter. "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." He went away a second time and prayed, "My Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done." When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went away once more and prayed the third time, saying the same thing. Then he returned to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour has come and the Son of Man is delivered into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer."
Nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song must end. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. I've got one response, I got just one move. With my arms stretched wide, I will worship you. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a
God, we just come before you now in thanksgiving and praise, Lord. And we pray in Jesus' name that you'll be breaking down walls tonight, that you will be allowing each of us to worship you with our whole hearts, with our whole selves, with everything we have, with everything we are, Lord. You are so, so good. You are so, so good, Lord.
Except for a heart singing hallelujah,
above all kingdoms, above
Matthew 26 from 47. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. Take a seat. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him. Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus replied, "Do what you came for, friend." Then the man stepped forward, seized Jesus, and arrested him. With that, one of Jesus' companions reached for his sword, drew it out, and struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his ear. "Put your sword back in its place," Jesus said to him. "For all who draw the sword will die by the sword. Do you think I cannot call on my Father, and he will at once put it at my disposal more than 12 legions of angels? But how then would the scriptures be fulfilled that say it must happen in this way?" In that hour, Jesus said to the crowd, "Am I leading a rebellion that you have come out with swords and clubs to capture me? Every day I sat in the temple courts teaching, and you did not arrest me. But this has all taken place that the writings of the prophets might be fulfilled." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. Tonight was an opportunity to worship our Lord and our Savior, an opportunity to start preparing our heart and surrendering to Him as we come to this Easter weekend. And so coming into the next song, we just want to provide the opportunity for you to continue to do that, surrendering your heart. Maybe there's something that's holding you back at the moment. Maybe it's been a big week for you and there's just something racing around in your mind. Tonight's an opportunity to just give that over to God and prepare your heart for this special time that we call Easter. The special time where Jesus died and rose again. And so we've just got the cross here, as you can see. We have sticky notes and pens. We would love people to symbolically come forward and write down what it is that they need to hand over to God and just let go so that their heart is ready for the weekend. Maybe there's something right now that you're thinking of. And so during the next song, while the team are playing, why don't you come forward with whatever it is that you have, write it down, and stick it on the cross as if you're giving it to God. Come as you feel led. Thank you, team.
A moment when the lights went out, when death had claimed its victory, the King of Love had given up his life, the darkest day in history. There on a cross they made for sinners, for every curse his blood atoned. One final breath and it was finished, but not the end we could have known. For the earth began to shake and the veil was torn. Sacrifice was made as the heavens roared. All hail, King Jesus. All hail, the Lord of heaven and earth. All hail.
Eternity. The King of Life was on the move, for in a dark, cold tomb, where our Lord was laid, one miraculous prayer with
Jesus.
death could not hold you. I felt all before you. Your silence, the voice of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names.
Death could not hold you.
Death could not hold.
Offer this heart of
we stand here with arms high and hearts abandoned. Lord, help us to surrender all that we have and all that we are to you. Holy Spirit, may you do something with this weekend with us. Change our hearts, renew us, transform us, Lord, into more like you, Jesus. Lord, help us to have fresh revelations of you this weekend. May you convict us. May you encourage us. Help us to praise and bless your name with all that we have. In Jesus' mighty, powerful, and beautiful name. And the church said, Amen. Thank you so much for coming tonight, church. If you would like prayer before you go, please come down the front. Otherwise, we'll see you tomorrow morning and Sunday morning. Thank you so much.